vlog that I said I was going to do that I haven't done, and I've tried, really I have, was about being cryogenically frozen. And for some reason, every time I try to record this freaking vlog, it's like a sign from the universe to not do it. It's God smiting me. I don't think it's that. I think I just have problems. So yeah, I want to be cryogenically frozen. I know that sounds all sci-fi and crazy. And honestly, it does to me sound all sci-fi and crazy, which is kind of cool. But, you know, also kind of crazy. And I get it. It's one of those things that people, they fantasize about, but I don't think a lot of people actually do it. But I honestly really actually want to do it. I want to be cryogenically frozen. Very much so. There is a place called Alcor. It's in Arizona, I believe. And I'm going to put links in my description, so check it out. You don't have to check it out because you want to be cryogenically frozen. Just check it out because it might be interesting. And it also, you know, will clear up some of the things that I'm going to try to explain, but I'm sure I'll explain them horribly. But anyway, yeah, so I really do want to be cryogenically frozen. My reason is that I feel like it's, you're going to be dead anyway. Either you're going to die and you're going to be dead, or you're going to die, you're going to get cryogenically frozen, and it's going to work, and you could wake up in the future, and that would be so cool. So cool. Because if it doesn't work, like I said, you'll just be dead. So why not take a chance on it? Because I feel like you're not really losing. I mean, yeah, it's expensive, but I don't feel like you're losing a lot. It's not like you'll be more dead. I guess for some people who have certain religious beliefs, I suppose to them, perhaps it's a sin or something. Luckily, I am a agnostic atheist, so I think it sounds cool. And I don't think that there's anything wrong with it. Yeah, so I want to take a chance and hopefully wake up in the future. And the way that I understand it, which definitely is gonna be kind of wrong. I mean, not wrong, but just not as good as the site can explain it, which is exactly why you should go read it on the site. But the way that you get cryogenically frozen, it's better if you just have your head frozen, because then they can focus on the most important part, which is your brain. And you know, I am assuming that if I can be woken up in the future, probably shouldn't assume this, but I'm hoping slash assuming that if I can be woken up in the future, science will have also found a way to somehow give me a body of some kind. Now I'm going to talk about what kind of body that I want, because, you know, making demands. Oh my God, people, stop blowing up my phone. But yes, first, cryogenics. So basically, focusing on the head is better, because it, you know, Yeah, because the brain is in the head, obviously, and that's what you want to keep, is the brain where all your thoughts and memories and blah, blah, blah is stored. And they don't just throw you into a freezer. No, no, no. Actually, doing that would pretty much ensure that you will never wake up. You know, like we have like, I think it's, what is it, 70% water or something? We have a lot of water in our bodies. When water freezes, it expands, and if we have all this water in us and each cell has, you know, moisture, then yeah, then it would expand and damage that cell. So they do something where they try to take out the water part of it and put in some sort of freezing agent, which helps, you know, it's not 100%. There is still some damage to the cells, but it's, you know, better than nothing. And then I guess the idea is later on, through scientific advancements, they will be able to regenerate the cells that you lost and give you a new body of some kind. I feel a little bit concerned that I won't be me, because there'll be damage to my cells and they'll have to be regenerated. But I feel like if my cells are damaged, I'll still probably be me. I just might not be as me as I am now. I'll be a little bit different, but I'll still, in essence, I'll have most of what makes me me still there, because there'll be enough good cells left with the memory of who I am now to, you know, still have me, meanness in them. I feel like if there is a, let's say, soul of the brain, then I don't think it will be destroyed in the process. I think I will still be myself, enough of myself to be myself still, if that makes sense. 'Cause when people go through, you know, accidents and suffer brain damage, let's say someone went through an accident and suffered brain damage, but they were able to recover. What the hell? For reals? Worst road ever. Good choice, Carrie. Oh my God. How long does this go on for? Ugh, goodness. Pretty much for the whole ride? Awesome. All right, well, we'll just have to power through it. Anyway, let's say someone has brain damage, but they can recover from it. Well, did they lose their soul? No. I mean, they're still the same person that they were before. Even though if they recover 100%, they might change from the experience somehow. I mean, and that doesn't mean they're not them still. It just means that going through stuff and recovering from stuff and experiencing stuff changes you. I'm not scared of that. I'm scared of waking up and it being scary and different and having to learn all kinds of new things. But I'm hoping that it'll be a good thing rather than, you know, I wake up and then boom, I'm enslaved to some alien race. So, yeah, I'm not worried about, oh, I'm not gonna be me. I'm sure I'll be me and I'm sure I'll be different. But hopefully it'll be a good different. And I can't see myself becoming so different that I lose who I am. I just think that, like any experience or anything that we go through, it will definitely change me, because that's huge. You just woke up in the future with a brand new body, like, plus some new brain cells, because a few of them got destroyed. That's a big thing to go through. I mean, of course I'm going to be different, but I'm still going to be me. In a way, I'll just be me later on in the future. And that'll be cool, because I'll be future me. And if future me is watching this, what is up? Future me is probably like, this dumb bitch.